have some money markets, sir. For that, we have some risks.
Okay.
What are the arrangements for that risk, sir?
You mean to say, what are the...
For controlling that risk.
Okay. What are the money market risk controlling measures? Maybe, first of all, we need to be clear on what are the risk areas that people have as participants, as investors, as buyers in money market. The major risk is credit default risk. Credit default risk, or in short, credit risk. Okay? When you have credit risk, the counter guarantee risk is in the hands of RBI. RBI takes care of credit default risk.
How we measure that credit risk, measuring of that credit risk?
Usually there are several instruments which are there in money market. Through their instruments, like repo market is there, call money market is there, bill discounting market is there. Anywhere participants in the market are the risk sources. So to become a participant, RBI or the market itself gives a criteria that itself takes care of risk management.
Sir, what is the difference between inland bill and foreign bill?
Okay, this is related to bill of exchange. Inland bill is all about domestic business or trade, and foreign bill is all about imports and exports. That's the basic difference.
Is the Treasury Bill serves as a benchmark, sir?
Yeah, Treasury Bill, a benchmark for what do you mean?
For the services.
Okay.
Is the Treasury Bill serves as a benchmark?
When you talk about benchmark, it is a interest rate. Benchmark interest rate, more than repo rates, earlier it used to be bank rate. Right now, we have repo rate as the benchmark, but not the interest rate offered on treasury bills. Okay, but treasury bill is the benchmark in terms of its size and volume of trade.
What is CD equivalent
yield? CD, first of all, you are talking about certificate of deposit, right? Yeah. Well, corporates deposit money in banks, that is usually certificate of deposit, where the tenure is very short. Tenure is very short, and that becomes benchmark for other instruments also, because this is considered to be, as you're talking about risk, one of the lowest risk bearing money market instrument is CD. So with commercial paper or some other instrument, IBPC or some other instrument, when people want to invest, they look at the interest rate or the return or the yield. So that they look at CD rate is a benchmark rate which is risk-free. So usually that is the benchmark. If some other instrument is risky, it should be greater than CD. So because this is risk-free, it should be the lowest. If there is something risky, there should be a premium added to that risk.
Federal funds.
Sorry?
Federal funds.
Federal, the word federal is used in American context, not in Indian context. So whatever the securities are issued by Federal Reserve Bank on behalf of government of US, okay, that's a kind of fundraising process. So that you called as funds for the sake of Federal Reserve, federal funds. In India, treasury bills serve that purpose. It is for the sake of government.
Sir, how the RBI controls the credit and money markets? In what way the RBI controls?
Okay. RBI keeps very vigilant watch on money markets. Why? Because the objective is to stabilize the prices, stabilize interest rates, stabilize forex rate. This is for consistent GDP growth rate. This happens. If this has to happen, someone has to monitor. And as you rightly asked, RBI is the body in India which closely monitors the credit or money supply or interest rates.
Sir, in what way the RBI creates the money?
Okay.
In what?
When you talk about money, it's all about printing and printing currency and minting coins. That is money. But in addition to that, when RBI feels to what extent money should be there in the economy, that's very important. If it is more than the desired level, it will suck the money. If it is less than what is desired, it will pump the money. That's how it stabilizes the whole economy through money supply.
Sir, we have interbank participatory certificates.
Okay.
Where and why you have issued that, sir?
Interbank participatory certificates is all about priority sector lending. It is related to priority sector lending. For example, agriculture sector, startup funding, export funding, women entrepreneurship. These are the prioritized areas in India. Importantly, agriculture. All the commercial banks have to meet the target. Out of the total assets, how much is there for priority sector? That has to be there. If a bank is more than that, say for example, my bank has 40% priority sector lending and I'm trying to give more. It is of no use for me. But there is another bank where it is in short. It didn't meet the target. Then in that case, that bank can buy IBPCs from me where RBI terms accepts that as priority sector lending equivalent.
How we explore interest rate swaps?
Sorry?
Interest rate swaps.
Interest rate swaps is all about, you asked about risk management. This is one of the risk management tool in money market. When a loan is taken on floating, you have taken a rate on floating, I have taken a loan on fixed rate, and you feel you are not comfortable, I feel I'm not comfortable, we exchange the interest rate, I mean the loans. Means I will take flexible exchange rate or floating rate and you will take fixed exchange rate. This you call it a swap. Okay?
How we measure the credit risk in purpose of like swap?
Okay. That is very tough question to answer. Why? Because credit risk in swaps is customized. It is not market driven. Like you have derivative markets. Stock exchanges offer derivative instruments. If they are offered like that, then credit risk is zero. But credit swaps happen between two parties. Counterparty is the risk. But as you rightly mentioned, there is more scope for credit risk where one may default. What if you don't oblige? But there is a controlling mechanism for that also.
What are interest rate collars?
When you say swaps, you have plain vanilla where you have very simple terms and conditions. When things are beyond that, then you will have exotic options, collar swaps kind of thing. They have very customized features, which are a little complicated. Okay? Any questions, friends, from you?
Sir, recently the Jalan Committee has transferred the...
Recommended to transfer.
Is this really useful? Is it good or not to the society or
anyone? Okay, in Indian context, people are yelling on Modi's government for the past 2 years. But it's all about how rich RBI is, how liquid RBI is, how much cash cushion RBI has. To suffice its own liquidity priorities, it is comfortable, it is sitting above it, then it's not a problem. So accordingly, Bimal Jalan Committee suggested to transfer 1.76 lakh crores to GOI to reduce the fiscal deficit. Fiscal deficit is one of the culprit which hints GDP growth rate. Okay? If the fiscal deficit is narrowed, it enables any government to go ahead with infrastructural development and growth rate of GDP. That's a good move, good suggestion, and good acceptance and implementation by RBI. Any questions, friends? Ajay? Okay.
Many companies like national company are suggesting that the CRR should be transferred to the banks from RBI.
Transfer to?
Commercial banks.
Okay.
That means if a bank got default, the CRR money also should be given to the commercial bank without keeping it to the RBI. How could you comment in there?
No, your question is in point of view when a banks go bankrupt. That's what, in terms of default, you say, yeah, that is good. If a bank defaults, is there any instance in the recent scenario or in the recent decades that a bank has defaulted? And in Indian context, we don't have that. See, a bank has to maintain CAR according to Basel norms. According to RBI norms, it has to, we are well above Basel II norms to maintain CAR. And RBI prescribes CRR and SLR at the determined level and with changes. That is to safeguard the investors, depositors, borrowers. That is the reason you never saw a commercial bank in India defaulting. All the banks will go, will have ups and downs. Maybe that is what Nirmala Sitharaman was saying as a reason for mergers, including Andhra Bank. Chandrababu Naidu is saying no. Please leave Andhra Bank or continue the same brand name. Okay? Their objective is different. But when Oriental Bank of Commerce acquired Global Trust Bank in the tenure of UPA, that is the reason because Global Trust Bank was caught in capital market scam that was almost about to default. In that case, your question will come. So what happens to CRR? What happens to shareholders? Yeah, I'm with you. Anyone else?
Is the interbank participation certificate is helpful for the banking sector?
I think he was asking that bank, maybe, yeah. It may not be useful for banking sector, but it will bring balanced regional development. In macroeconomics, you have that. Any governments or finance ministers have that policy, balanced regional development. So for that, RBI stipulated prioritized sectors where all the banks have to meet. Even if they don't meet, they need to encourage some other banks who are in surplus. They want to lend more to the priority sector. At the same time, they get the advantage. So that way, that is very useful for commercial banking also.
What is the marginal cost for funding-based lending rates?
Okay. That is a kind of a strategic move. Marginal cost of funding base lending rate, there is a stipulation that what is your base rate? Each and every bank will give base rate. Okay? The banks cannot violate their own base rate. Each bank will have their own base rates. Why? Because on what rate they are offering the deposits and on what rate they are giving the loans. The net is the profit. But what banks claim is, sir, earlier we used to give deposits at 10%, but recently we have given deposits only on 7%. So now you please allow us to bring down the loan rates because our marginal cost of borrowing from depositors is less. Then marginal cost of lending should also be less. That is their appeal.
So what is the status of swap agreements under the banking law?
In India, it is not that active, I should say that. But when you talk about derivatives market in the world, it is one of the biggest in terms of size. Because European and American banks, they do have a lot of swaps. Swapping interest rate and swapping the currency. Both it happens.
What is aggregation or interconnection risk?
Aggregation or interconnection risk, it happens within the bank, interbank things where syndicate loans, you might have, maybe that's the reason for Nirmala Sitharaman's announcement of banks merger. What she said is, we are too small to lend. we should be big enough to lend. And what did they do? Even Chidambaram, when he was the finance minister, he also proposed the same. Ours is one of the biggest economies, and none of our bank, including SBA, is there in top 100 banks in the world. So that is the reason. So this syndication is a kind of aggregation of banks to make it bigger, and risk is also shared.
So why the commercial banks are majorly contributing?
What are the other banks you mean to have, apart from commercial banks?
Like other financial institutions.
Okay. So, you have NBFCs, you have regional rural banks, you have development banks, you have commercial banks. Earlier, development banks were there, their role is there to support respective industries. But now their role has come down. So, commercial banks' role has gone up. They are everything for business, trade, investment, markets. That's the reason they're so good, so big. Any other question quickly? Last question.
Sir, they have monetary policy measures. They have monetary policy rates. They can make the bi-monthly all of the times. In what measures they can, on what parameters they can fix the rates? That means there is a proposal from RBI and government.
Okay, I had been always telling and referring to why we retained Subba Rao, ex-RBI governors. The mechanism of changing the benchmark repo rates, that all depends on money supply, inflation, prices, foreign exchange rates, unemployment rate, output, stock market indices. There are many parameters to consider. Okay? So, based on that, RBI will take a call on advice maybe from the finance minister or financial markets commission or committee, whatever. They will analyze the whole country, economy, markets and so on, and they feel that, yeah, this is the time to have a rate cut or rate increase. There is no fixed method for that. It's all about policy making and acting accordingly to the given scenario. I think we are done. Thank you all for your participation. Let us meet again after Unit 3. Thank you.